amigos, are you ready to receive communion? Are you ready to receive Jesus for the first time? For the first time, how many of you are ready? Ready! All right, let's see. The hands are ready. So every time, like I see Brian all the time, and whenever he comes, goes like that, I almost want to give him communion all the time because I know that he's been ready for a while. Very good. So I know you guys have been looking at your parents and your brothers receiving communion. Now, this day forward, you will receive Jesus in your bodies. Isn't that amazing? Es algo maravilloso, ¿no? Que van a recibir el Señor en tu cuerpo. ¿Eh? El Señor va a entrar en tu cuerpo este día y por siempre va a ser cambiado. You will be changed forever because of who you will receive, whom you will receive today. Huh? Can you imagine that? Where is Jesus? After today, when you receive the Eucharist, when someone tells you, where is Jesus? What's your answer? Jesus is in me. Right? Jesus is in me. There's that song, right? Jesus is in me and Jesus is in you. Jesus is in us for he loves us. Right? And this is because of the love of God for you. Este es porque Dios les ama. Because God loves you. Jesus loves you. So he wants you. He wants to be in your body. He wants to be in your life. That is why it's important that we understand that this is something special. That's why you're all dressed like this. You don't dress like this when you go to just your party in your neighborhood, right? You go like this because there's something very, very special happening to all of you today. As you receive Jesus in your bodies, you become a temple. Van a ser templos de Dios. Why? God lives in the temple. God resides in the temple. God is in the temple, right? Like when we go to church here, when we go to church here, where is Jesus? ¿Dónde está el Señor Jesús? Está ahí en el tabernáculo, ¿no? Está ahí en el tabernáculo. Sabemos que allá dentro del tabernáculo, especialmente cuando vemos que hay luz allá frente del tabernáculo, significa que el Señor, la luz del mundo, el alimento de nuestro cuerpo, de nuestra alma, está allá en la iglesia. That's why when you come to church, what is the first thing that you do? You acknowledge where Jesus is, correct? Right? You say Jesus, and then you make a genuflection. El respeto de la presencia de Dios. So you genuflect and genuflect in your one knee, correct? But when you enter the church, cuando entra en la iglesia, la primera cosa que dice que, ah, hola, Señor Jesús. Humildemente, reconozco tu presencia. So that's the first thing. Now, however, now, what's going to happen when you receive Jesus? You will also be a temple. You will also be like a tabernacle, right? Therefore, God will be in you. Jesus will be in you. So what does this mean? This means that you are also sacred, just like the tabernacle. So my suggestion is this. Mi sugestión para ustedes es cada día en la mañana, cuando empieza el día y entra al baño, you look at the mirror in your bathroom, you go and say, You are a temple of God. Cada día, antes de cepillarse, antes de bañarse, and antes de hacer algo en el baño, ¿no? Diferente. Empieza con decir en la mañana, ¿no? Reconocer, recordar, ¿no? Recordar. Tú eres el templo de Dios. And then you do your thing, right? You do your thing for the day. Always remember that today, from this day forward, you're the temple of God. That's why you have to take care of the temple, right? Tiene que cuidar el templo. Tiene que limpiar el templo. Tiene que ayudar al templo para que el templo respeta el Señor que está viviendo adentro de ti. Entonces, you have to take care of your body. In other words, you have to be healthy, to live healthy. Sometimes maybe the things that we do are not helpful for our bodies. Maybe we're not eating vegetables, and we only like mac and cheese. Mac and cheese every day, not good for your temple. Yeah? You gotta think of eating well, eating healthy. Ejercicio, ¿no? Ejercicio también, para que no esté enfrente de la televisión, haciendo algo, mirando la televisión todo el día, o o no está ayudando el cuerpo para ser sana, sano el cuerpo. Entonces, you have to help your bodies in a special way now, also to be healthy, and not only healthy, but also holy, especially holy. How do you keep your temple holy? By not committing any sins, right? And that is why when you came to church, before you even received your first communion, what did you do first? You had your first... What? Very good, very good. You had your first reconciliation. Fueron a la iglesia para recibir el perdón del Señor, para limpiar tu alma, para cuando venga el Señor en tu cuerpo, ¿están listo para recibirlo? ¿No? Porque están limpias. Este es algo importante. We try to avoid committing any sin in order that the Lord Jesus will be less unworthy. They'll be more prepared to have the Lord reside in us. Okay? Este es algo importante, ¿no? Huh? So today you are changed, children. Today you are changed. And it is my prayer, es mi oración para ustedes, que cada día de tu vida van a pensar qué significa para recibir al Señor en el Santísimo Sacramento como alimento de tu cuerpo, especialmente de tu alma. Huh? If you will think about it every day, whenever you receive Jesus in Holy Communion, that you remember how much God loves you, that He comes and He allows you to receive Him as food for your body and for your spirit. Y quiero también tomar este momento para hablar con los padres, to talk to the parents, to the godparents, to the family. You know, these are young people. They're young, they can't help it. I hope that they will treasure this by the way you teach them how important what they are receiving today. Que van a enseñarlos por la importancia de qué está recibiendo en este momento, por su recepción del Santísimo cada domingo, sino cada día, ¿no? Cada domingo, cada vez que entran en la iglesia, y ayúdalos entonces a preparar bien por este sacramento que van a recibir otra vez en diferentes maneras de su vida. You know, this is the only really true way that we are united together as one. We are united more than any other thing, más que todas las cosas. Toda la iglesia de Dios, toda la familia de Dios reúne en la recepción compartiendo el sagrado misterio del cuerpo y sangre de Cristo. La familia de Dios comen juntos en la mesa del altar de nuestra salvación para recibirmos el alimento de nuestro Señor. This is the real unity of the entire church. Más que está en México, más que está en Sudamérica, en Asia, en Europa y África o Antártica o en la Luna, recibimos el Santísimo Sacramento y con este sacramento reunimos la iglesia. And therefore, you children are going to be united in a special way with all the other temples of God that have received this special gift. And with everyone, we say thanks be to God for what you will become today. Amen.